In this unit, we will have fun. Somehow, in the last couple of days on Facebook, a discussion broke out what Sebastian's weight is. And I decided, rather than telling people how much I weigh, I turn this into statistics. And up front, I want you to put everything together we've done so far using programming. And since programming has been optional in this class, consider this unit optional. But it'd be great if you had a chance to try it. It's not that hard. And in the end of the day, you know something about me that I rarely discuss in public. Through a comment I made in class on Facebook, a discussion erupted in our Facebook Stats 101 discussion group, what my actual weight is. And here is the form that I posted, where I asked students to submit their best estimate how much I weigh in kilograms, and also to submit how much they thought I weighed a year ago. And within a few hours, there was a good number of guesses, including this one over here. That's about as much as the planet Pluto weighs. And also some negative guesses. These are about the negative weight of Pluto each. But other than that, there were lots of really good guesses. And you can see in kilograms, some people think I weigh 80 or 65. Others think I weigh 250. So I took the guesses and added them into a large list called weight. There's just below 100 of those. And now I want to do statistics on those. The very first thing I did is I printed the mean estimate, and it turns out to be negative. It's minus 2 to the 1, 0, to the 10 to the 20th. And that's a typical situation in statistics. When you look at those numbers, most of them are actually pretty good guesses. But these extreme guesses of 10 to the 22 or minus 10 to the 22 over here completely affect and screw up the actual statistics. Now, you've learned how to deal with this. You know everything about statistics. What I want you to do is to now code a piece of software called Calculate Weight that does three things. And I think you can do all three of them yourself. First, I want you to remove the outliers by only extracting data between the lower and upper quartile. It turns out the number of data points make it well-defined what the lower and upper quartile is. In all test cases we run through, we'll have a well-defined number of data points. And all the test cases we'll be using will have the property that the lower and upper quartile are well-defined elements. Then I want you to fit a Gaussian using the maximum likelihood estimator. And from that, I want you to compute the value x that corresponds to the standard score z. So I'm giving you not just the weight statistics, the weight data, but also where my actual weight is. If you plug in the standard score of minus 2, which is 2 standard deviations below the mean of the data of people estimated, you'll find out my actual weight this morning that I took this morning. It's amazingly accurate. Put differently, the data that you guys provided for this was overestimating my weight, I'm happy to report, by 2 standard deviations. So all these formulas are known, and I think you have all the coding skills necessary from the past to fill these gaps. Obviously, the first step is the hardest. And when you're done with it, this command over here will give you the correct answer.